You've learned how to open your speech, how to engage the audience. It's all about how you bring it all in for the closure. Because what you want to do is when you're able to learn how to close your speech and leave the audience wanting more, that wanting more element is quite significant. Why? It's not necessarily wanting more that they want to hear you more on the stage at this point in now. It's about wanting more of you. Because as you're speaking, whether the audience knows you for the first time or not, they want to build a better relationship with you. You probably said something very powerful, very instrumental, had a very much a meaning to them. And so they want to be associated with you, whether it's following you on social media, whether it's learning about the work you do. So how do you build that relationship post-event? And all of it is done through the how you close your speech. So we're looking to three key elements. One is about knowing how to and when to signal the end of your speech. Secondly, it's about summarizing key takeaways, the important messages from your speech. And thirdly, is about having a call to action. So how do you signal the end? Very simple, very straightforward. Let's say you've given a 20-30 minute speech and you need to signal the end. You just need to say things like in summary or in conclusion. At least that way it triggers the end of your speech and the audience is okay, you're entering the last couple of minutes, right? Secondly, it's about summarizing the key takeaways. Now, what does that mean? For example, if you're delivering a story or you're sharing a message that has multiple segments, you want to take one or two points, maybe 3 points from each of those elements of the speech to be able to bring in the key message right at the end. To give you an example, I talk often about the 7 P's, but to make it short and easy, I'll mention 3 of them. And 7 P's include, in this time, 3 include positivity, having a positive mindset, passion, which is about happiness and doing what you love, and perseverance, working hard. So I will use those 3 elements just to sum up and wrap up my speech. And it gives the audience a takeaway from the whole body of the speech in what it is that I was sharing with them. So I don't have to repeat myself over and over again. And finally, have a call to action. Now, this is a great opportunity in terms of directing the audience in terms of where you want them to go and what you want them to do. And that is critical because you don't want to be somebody who's speaking at an event and you're just delivering your 20-30 minute speech and all of a sudden you say goodbye and you hear nothing of the audience or you leave them with no form of action. So to give you an example, as part of the Inspire 1 Million campaign I ran for 4 years between 2010 and 2014, I encouraged every single attendee to be able to go onto the Inspire 1 Million website and upload a small image of themselves to be a part of the Inspire 1 Million campaign. That way I could track exactly how many people I've inspired along the way. So at least that way I was able to point them towards a direction. Maybe you're running a charity or a fundraising event and you want people to be able to donate post the event. So you give them the direction to that website or how to donate. So you're at least giving them something to do or go to, or even if it is subscribing to your email or following you on social media, you're having a call to action. And all of this plays a critical role. So when it comes to how to close your speech and leave the audience wanting more, remember, signal the end, which is very easy and straightforward to do. Summarize the key takeaways in a nutshell, the body of your speech in a couple of sentences, and have a call to action so you know where to guide your audience.